Sorbonne was the headquarters of the Joint Provincial Council of Chiefs, and that is why the meeting took place there. It was a unity movement which incorporated all existing groups. Obeche Bilante brought the League of Golgokos, Dankwa brought Youth Conference, Pagran was the chairman, and Dankwa was the political leader. The constitution is available. The constitution says in clear terms that they had to fight for independence. When the 1948 riots occurred, the great emancipation declaration was made by J.B. Dankwa on behalf of all them. The decision, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, was taken on that day. The Golgokos should be free, translated into a modern Ghana. The seed was sown. Nkrumah came later. He added to it. The truism is that he was not even in Ghana when he started, and he was not the founder. He was a leading participant. He acknowledged. Dankwa conceived the idea of calling the independent Golgokos Ghana, and this was formally adopted in Sorbonne. When they met in Sorbonne, they chose the name. That name is with us today. And in fact, it became known to every child in the Golgokos that Ghana will soon become independent. Our leaders were fighting for it. That new nation will be called Ghana. And it happened, or at least it started, before Nkrumah arrived.